Hi, I'm Nate, and you're watching Photolearningism. Let's take a look at the brand new release of KDEN Live, and specifically an awesome new feature about translating your audio into subtitles automatically. Let's check it out. So once again, I'm Nate. This is Photolearningism. Thank you so much for joining in. If it's your first time here, I do a lot of work on this channel to surface the cheap or free art technologies so that you can know about them and make good use of them. Thank you so much for joining in. So as I mentioned, I wanted to look at the brand new release of KDEN Live, KDE, and Live. I never really know how to say that, but that's my stab at it. There is version 21.04. And it comes with some new interesting things, one of which I'll highlight today. Let's jump into that. This is the version here. It comes with a subtitle generator. We've looked at the subtitle layer in the timeline before. This is something completely different. So I want to kind of step into this slowly because getting into this new version came with some caveats, and for your benefit, I just want to explain them quickly. So there is a warning out there on the website that when you download this new release, you have to remove the previous version. Pay attention to that. I ignored that because I wanted to see what would happen, and it throws a really weird error about how the defaults aren't working when you start it up, and it's like an infinite loop of click OK, cancel, and it never goes anywhere. So that's the outcome of not uninstalling it. Now, I'm suspicious that even if you do, this is the important part, because I did uninstall it and then try it again, is that KDEN Live leaves behind an install folder if you're on Windows in the program files directory. This is the 64-bit directory. I had to rename that while it was uninstalled and then do a fresh install using this latest installer, and it finally took. Even then, I still got a warning as I launched it up, but I was able to cancel out of that and it came up. So just be aware that there's a little bumpy road getting into it. The easiest thing to do is before you even start, uninstall the version you have, check for this folder, rename it if it's still there, get the new installer, run it fresh, and you should be good, in theory. So, having put those on the table and gotten to this point, now, this was really tricky. This is a really innovative, amazing technology at play here. I wish it was a little more intuitive to set up. That's why we have a video dedicated to this, because there was a lot involved to do it. So just taking a quick poke here, first of all, let's go into the settings and configure KDEN Live. Some of this should look fairly familiar, except now there's this speech to text piece here. You will have to go out to the site here, and this is also in the instructions as well, but it opens up here, and you can take your pick from some models. I went ahead right for this first one here. It's the biggest. I was trying to get really as much of the model as I could. There is a minimal model here, which I haven't played with too much, but this is kind of more focused on phones, and I want a larger dictionary. So this one, again, is English. If you're looking for another language, they do have other versions further down that are sizable. I'll look for the models down there. I went with this one and took it down. All right. So you will have to do that. There are also some instructions to get through. I don't know how much setup you actually have to do, because I had so much trouble getting it to work, and I tried all these different things. So I'll talk about my troubleshooting after the fact. Let's assume a perfect world where you have installed it properly the first time, where you've removed the old one, put the new one in, came up clean, you download your model, you go into KDEN Live, into the configuration, speech to text. You do have to put a check in this box here, and then you have to select where you're going. This is tricky in that you have to select the top folder. The reason there's two here is because I unzipped it, so it's like a folder inside of itself. So I'm going to repoint in here. So we have the model that I wanted. Actually, we could really do either one of these, but I want to do this one. Yep. And then from here, as soon as you can see this level, I'll click inside of it so you can see. If you see this, you've gone too far. it actually will let you select this, which is kind of a confusing point. In fact, I'll do that so you can see. And it'll even provide options of, yeah, you've got speech models here. They don't work. All right? The piece of it that it needs, it actually doesn't read this way. So what you have to do is you have to go up a level to the point where you can see this point, select the folder, click on it, click check configuration, and that should be all you need to do for that point. Now, I again had some problems. You may get this check for update, which you're free to do. It will cycle through to make sure that the VOSC is up to date and the other frameworks are there. That part was actually really good because it helped me fill in some of the gaps, but ideally you shouldn't have to, because it comes packaged with Python, it comes packaged with some of the components. You may have to update Python manually to get an updated version of PIP, it's called. That's another dependency if you look on the site about what it needs to run. So that's kind of a nugget of things. I did run some commands on the side, which I'll put up here, and you can see what I ran. I don't ultimately know if that caused a difference just because of the kinds of things I was trying to do, but that's what I did. In case you run into trouble, it's worth a try. All right, so select this level and click OK. And then to use it, a quick way into it is I have a clip here that has audio. It has, as you can see, some thing. It's a clip of me. And I do a lot of talking. You do need to expose the subtitle level or layer, which is this button here. And then to access the wizard, really, for doing the speech-to-text is actually right here. This remote-looking button, the wand, I guess it is. On the instructions, they have a different-looking window with different buttons. And I haven't figured out how to show that, okay? So if you're looking at the user manual picture, that doesn't add up yet. I'm not quite sure if that's future. If you're able to get there, let me know how, because I couldn't figure that out. But using this, I was still able to achieve the feature. So the wand, that brings up this dialog window. It has the one and only model that we picked. And the instructions do say right now that this is the only mode that's supported, is timeline zone all tracks, all right? I didn't see in the instructions about this, but I noticed this, that I was testing things out. I dragged out the timeline zone here, down here, and it only seems to work inside of that selected space. I think that's just still part of the way it's working right now. I think they plan to enhance it, but just to be aware of that, that seems to be a limitation, is that that needs to be extended over the space you're looking to do. Now, you would click process. And I'm not going to do that now, because it actually took about a full 2 minutes of just chalking and working on it just to work on this small 5-second clip. So, yeah, that seems like a lot, but think about it this way. It is algorithmically analyzing the sound patterns, comparing it to a language model, and spitting out words without you having to do anything. All right, so that's worth waiting for. I have a clip here where I said a couple things.
You're watching Total Learnism. We got a ton of questions about using.
So that was a small clip, and it's actually pretty intelligent. I say the words photo learningism, which is not really a real word. That's my channel name. But it took a very honest stab, and it came up with, for to learn to use them, which is actually really intelligent that it actually found matched words that sound like what I'm saying. It's just not exactly the same. Now, yeah, in defense of this, I'm saying a word that doesn't exist. So that was the closest match, but it's still pretty cool that it found words. This is all accurate to what I said. And then I noticed that in my clip, I do say a word or two more here, but it was outside the selected range and it didn't pick it up. So that's why I'm suspicious that that actually is the case where it needs that selection to work. These subtitles are individual items, so I can edit them or tweak them. And the really cool part of all of this is that when it's all done, you've got your subtitle track all laid out. This will actually auto-size them, by the way, which is another really cool thing, in that it will space them appropriate to the stretch of words you're saying. So you don't even have to do that. You can go into, let's see, Project, Subtitles, export subtitle file. And you can export as an SRT, which I believe is the commonly accepted subtitle file to throw onto your videos. Wow! So it really is just that easy. It involves a little bit of patience. It involves a little bit of setup. But to have this technology in a free open source tool, nonetheless, is amazing. I am continually impressed by this tool, by the way. I speak a lot about it. Go check out some videos over there, that way, on KDEN Live, just to see the other magical elements of this tool. They have done so much work to make this tool valuable, and they don't charge a dime for it. They don't charge a penny. It's free. You lose nothing by trying it out. I can't say enough. Go download this tool and give it a shot. I see it as a strong competitor against commercial tools. It offers up to 4K resolution in and out, ingress, egress. It has proxy editing. It has so much built in that you would normally see only in a professional tool that is in this open source community-driven platform tool. So try it out. That is really the gist of what I hope to cover here, because again, this is kind of complicated stuff. Just to get to this point, we'll touch on the other features another time. So I hope that was interesting, and I really hope that gets you up to speed quick to try this new version, because this is very exciting, at least for me. And I'm looking forward to trying out this feature and actually offering that as an option for my clips, because others have asked me for the subtitles, and that's been kind of a tricky thing because it's time consuming to do that. And it's not that I don't want to give that, but I've got so much bandwidth, so this will help, I think. We'll give it a shot. Thank you so much for checking this out. If it was useful to you, please give me a thumbs up. Also, consider subscribing if you haven't done that already, so you don't miss out on the awesome projects we're going to be getting to in the future. And leave a comment, ask a question, and not just for me, but for the whole community of learners. I love it when I see all of us helping each other and assisting our endeavors to learn and become stronger with these technologies. So thank you so much. I will see you at the next video. Hi, I'm Nate, and you're watching Photo Learningism. Oh boy, that just derailed, right? Yikes. Hi, I'm Nate, and you're watching Photo Learningism. I wanted to show off some of the brand new, not some. No, that's not right.